what you are seeing on the screen right now is very important if you want to understand the Singularity Net and artificial general intelligence and how we will achieve it. I will explain it so it does kind of look confusing at first, but it will make a lot of sense. But before we get into it, make sure you tap the like button real quick. I don't have to remind any of you every single time you watch my videos. I hope you smash the like button because it does mean a lot. So please do it for me, do it for the algorithm, do it if you learn anything new or if you agree that SingularityNet is the future. So humans versus AGI. Although AGI is not meant to compete against humans, it's meant to help humans and advance us to levels unfathomable to the human brain. I just put versus for the purposes of this video. So we are not competing against each other. This will explain why the singularity will be achieved through AGI. So for example, now humans right here, as we can see, if Bob and Bill and Jill and Amen and Ronnie and all of these people go about their daily lives and they experience things, they see things, they learn things, they keep it to themselves. They cannot share it with one another. They cannot plug their brain into one another's brains and then learn from one another and experience what the other person is experiencing. That's impossible for humans. I think we can all agree on that, right? Like, there's no way we can do that. Our brains cannot handle that. AGI, where it is different, now we bring humanoids into the picture. For example, they can go out and work and help people and be out in the streets and the malls and airports and hospitals, and they learn just like humans. They see and hear things just like humans. They can move just like humans. But a major difference is that they can all be interconnected. They can all learn from one another. They can all upload what they have learned into a storage system that basically keeps on learning and learning and learning. And that is the idea of the singularity. And yes, it does seem like it is scary in many ways, like, oh, this thing is going to take over everyone's lives. But that means that we should make sure that it is benevolent. And that means that this AGI should be there to help us. So do not get scared from it, please. This video is not meant to scare anyone. But for example, right now, the major competitors we have are Apple, Google, and Amazon. Ben Gerstle, the SingularityNet team, have said that themselves, that these are the major AI players in the world. Now, why are we better than them? Or what strategic advantage do we have over them, I should say? Apple right now is focused just on smartphones, on laptops, on devices, which is really good, and they've done an amazing job at that. Google as well is a search engine. They do some devices, and they, for the most part, it's just machines, you know. Amazon, for example, they sell some AI services, but mostly they just ship boxes and products, you know. They don't have humanoids, they don't have super intelligent beings that they're working on at all. SingularityNet and Hanson Robotics, and these three right here are three organizations that you need to know about. The SingularityNet AGIX project, that's number one. Number two is Hanson Robotics. You need to know Hanson Robotics, you must. And number three is OpenCog. Just recently, Ben Gerstle and the team have updated the OpenCog algorithm, basically, and they are still working on it. Every couple of months, they're updating it, and it is very important. It's basically what runs the Singularity Net. OpenCog is very important. But basically, these three entities will spearhead this decentralized AI superintelligence project, because keyword is decentralized. Here, Apple, Google, Amazon, it's all centralized machine learning algorithms that they have up until this point. We SingularityNET wants to build a decentralized AI marketplace. So that means anyone like you and I watching have at our disposals AI services and products and humanoids and whatever we need at our fingertips. That is the beauty of it. And that's what they want to achieve. And that's what I am invested in. And the investment, speaking about it, here is the AGIX token. Theoretically, if we are successful over time, it should go to infinity almost. The singularity will literally be the most valuable invention ever if successful and if we can achieve it. Hands down, period. So over time, the value will be basically, it will be unlimited. So this is the price of the SingularityNET since it has come out. If you do not know, it's about 3 years old. And it basically went up right away, came down, was stuck in a range for a couple of years, and now it's just barely breaking out of it in the past 6 months. So we are still at the very early stages. Here is the SingularityNET. Basically, I'll leave a link to all of them down below. Here is the Hanson Robotics website. Make sure you check them out. And here is Hyperon OpenCog. This is a new update to OpenCog that I was speaking about, how OpenCog is constantly being updated. Hyperon OpenCog, OpenCog Hyperon is something that you need to know about. So again, everyone, if you appreciate this, if you got any value, or if you learned anything new, make sure you subscribe to this channel if you have not yet already, and smash the like button. I do not have to remind you. Please do that. I don't know where the accent came from. It's from desperation. Please, hopefully you got some value out of this, so you smash the like button. That is how you show your appreciation to me, because I appreciate you. So take care, everyone. Until next time, Mr. Mufleh, out.